We're pleased to be joined here today by six distinguished witnesses to discuss this important topic. First, Dr. Michael Scheuer is an adjunct professor at the Center for Peace and Security Studies at Georgetown University. Dr. Scheuer recently concluded a 22-year career with the CIA, where there Dr. Scheuer held multiple positions, including senior advisor for the Osama bin Laden department. We're very pleased to have you and honored, sir.
Next, in the Muslim world. And I would certainly, if I was in charge, change many of the policies we have. But it's more important that we in this country become adults. Nothing a person does in his life doesn't have a counter reaction. Does our foreign policy cause this war? Not a chance. The people who attacked us caused this war. Does our foreign policy motivate these people? Absolutely. Sir, if you're going to tell the American people they're fighting a war against a bunch of deranged, nihilist, fanatic extremists, we're going to be fighting a war that it's constantly going to surprise the American people about the costs of what they're doing. If we come to a place where we can have a discussion that says supporting Israel is essential to the U.S. security, supporting Saudi Arabia is important, vital to U.S. security, having U.S. troops in Muslim countries is vital to U.S. security, fine, but also tell the American people that costs come with that. Right now, we've spent 17 years in this war, and the American people still think we're fighting a bunch of long-haired, bearded, goat-eating madmen. And we're at a terrible disadvantage that we impose on ourselves, sir. And I would finish too long a statement by simply saying that we must stop the idiocy of democracy spreading. If you want to fight forever, keep trying to impose women's rights, secularism, the paganism of American culture, contemporary culture, on a religious civilization, sir.
Yeah, and I'll take
to make a comment. Professor Shaw, I've known you over the years, but I have to take sharp disagreement with your position about our support of Israel. I believe it is essential that the United States, for our security, continue to support Israel. I believe that if we back away from Israel or Jordan, for instance, using those countries, Morocco, as examples, that Al-Qaeda will find some other excuse. I mean, we can find any number of reasons. I can tell you during the 1990s, from after Iraq, but between 1995 and 2001, the only time the Americans used force overseas was to defend Muslims against Christians in Bosnia and in Kosovo. And yet the response by Al-Qaeda to that was to attack us on September 11th. So I think we make a mistake if we think we can somehow appease Al-Qaeda by taking away whatever they're...
Not at all a matter of appeasement, Mr. King, at all. If it was up to me, I'd dump the Israelis tomorrow.
I know you would. I know.
But all I worry about is the continuing preaching of American politicians to the American people that our relationship with the Israelis doesn't cause us to have dead Americans and extraordinary expenses in fighting the Muslim world.
I would just say we would have more dead Americans if we didn't stand by our allies in the Middle East.
Well,
we'd just be encouraging Al-Qaeda to take advantage of us. I think that...
Our allies in the Middle East are mostly totalitarian, sir, and they have been for 50 years.
There are not that many good people in the world. The fact is you have to work with those who work with us. And if I had the choice between dealing with the Israelis and Al-Qaeda, I work with Israel. If I had the choice between dealing with Jordan or Al-Qaeda, I deal with Jordan. And the fact is that you can find any number of excuses why Al-Qaeda is going to come after us.
No, sir, you can't.
Yes, I think you can.
No, you can't,
can.
Sir.
You certainly
Osama bin Laden would have been a terrific American politician because he stays on message. There's only one message that comes out of Al-Qaeda, and it's
that's the message they're using now. If it's not, there'll be some, if we pull out of Israel, if we
you
stop
have
supporting,
to depend.
No, I'm going to say if we stop supporting Israel, then the message will be
you have
America was cowardly, America was backed away, they're not going to stand by their allies. It's the flip side of everything, and I would rather stand with positive elements like Israel and back
down. I'm a bear of little brain, sir, but you got to go with what you go with at the moment. These people are fighting for something substantive, for something religious. And they're not fighting us for what reason do you suppose they're going to come up with? Because we have Hollywood? I would like to fight Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, they're not going to fight us because we have women in the workplace. That's an insanity. What they're fighting us about is what we do. And we don't have to stop what we're doing, sir. But we have to realize the cost.
And I think it'd be worse if we stop what we're doing, and that's my point.
Well, that's fine. Tell the American people that.
There's also a cost of what you're asking for, and I think that cost would be a lot greater.
I don't think so, sir.
Well,
it couldn't be worse than it is now.
We have to disagree.
You know, you're presiding over a bankruptcy. What can be worse? And what has been the goal of Al-Qaeda since it was formed? To bankrupt the United States. Who's winning today, sir? We're done like dinner.
We're winning and we'll continue to win unless we take the advice of people like
you.
Sir,
you are exactly wrong. Well, we are losing. Two U.S. field armies were defeated by men in the field with weapons from the Korean War.
The fact is, we have not been successfully attacked since September 11th.
The fact is, sir, we had two military defeats overseas.
The fact is, we have not been successfully attacked since September 11th.
Sir, that's a goofy argument. That is a goofy argument, sir.
I hate to gavel down the...
Well, I'm sure you're an expert on goofiness, so I yield back.
I appreciate the gentleman's spirited debate.
Again, I want to come back to understand some of the things you said. Before I do that, and I just want to mention this quickly, I find your position on our alliance with Israel as very troubling. It won't surprise you to tell you that I disagree with you. And you spent 17 years, is that right, or something like that, as a CIA analyst?
Over 20, sir.
Okay, over 20.
Not as an analyst, I ran operations, sir.
Okay. Would you say there's a large number of CIA analysts or employees who agree with your position?
I wouldn't dare to speak for anybody but myself, sir. Well, only a fool would know that our relationship with Israel causes us war with Muslims.
Well my question is fairly simple.
Yes, sir.
You worked with hundreds of employees.
Yes,
those,
sir.
You certainly
didn't work with any fools, sir.
You certainly had conversations with many of them. I'm asking for your opinion of, are there a large number who agree with you on this?
I'm not a McCarthyite, sir. I'm not going to say anything about that to you, sir.
Okay, well, I'm going to take that as non-responsive because it's a fairly simple question, and I don't
think... It's fairly none of your business about what my conversations with other people are about, sir.
I'm not asking for specifics of those conversations. I'm asking for your opinion of your experience, whether a large number that agreed with you. That's a fairly simple question. Hardly intrusive.
Very intrusive from my perspective, sir.
Well, okay, well, you can have your perspective.
Thank you,
I think,
sir.
Others can evaluate whether you're being agreeable or disagreeable.
I'm being disagreeable on this because
yes,
none of your business
are.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now, let me move on then. I would like you to explain very quickly, if you can, what you think the primary motivators are for Islamic jihadism.
First, our support for the Israelis.
Okay, that's your
second,
number. That's your.
No, it's there. There are six.
Okay, put them in order if you could.
Our support for tyranny for over 50 years in the Muslim world.
Okay.
As a trigger, our presence on the Arab Peninsula. Third, I would put the Israelis rising. Fourth, our ability for a long time to get oil at prices that were very much below the market level. Fifth, our presence, military presence, in other countries in the Muslim world. And sixth, our abiding willingness to identify as terrorist any Muslim population that one of our allies dislikes, whether it's the Russians or the Chinese.
Okay, let me,
those six things, sir.
I appreciate that. And let me say, and then I'm going to move on to other witnesses. I was an Air Force officer for 14 years. I have spent significant time with many people from that region. And it is astounding to me that you don't put in the top six what I know to be true, and that is they are motivated, many of them are motivated by their absolute hatred of the United States and what we represent, whether it's freedom, whether it's democracy, whether it's women's rights. There are many of them who are absolutely motivated by that. I know that. I have talked with them.
They hate them, sir.
And I can't imagine that you would not put that in some.
They're not going to die for that, sir.
Oh, they absolutely have.
They have not, sir.
Well,
this war is not.
You
wouldn't have anything
you
we have in this
professor,
country.
You are turning a blind eye to history for you to say that they won't
bullshit,
die
sir.
For that.
You cannot. You don't need to call me professor either. You should call me Mike. The reality is, no one has blown themselves up because this young lady.
Professor,
is in
you're absolutely wrong on that. I'm going to move on now.
Well, no, you pulled this up. You said there's millions
professor,
of people out there.
Professor, you're absolutely wrong on that. I'm going to move on if we could.
I wish you would move on.
For the rest of you, I'd like to ask you this in the very brief time that we have. Looking at